collection of objects. So objects, what we have taken, that should be well defined. For example, the students in the 10th class. So the students of 10th class are well defined. We know all the students, how many number of students in the class we have, the number of the students name. So the students of the 10th class, we know how many number of students we have in the class, and all the names of the students we know very well. So this kind of situation, we know that is called as a set. For example, the number of people, the people in a village, for example, people in a village, we don't know how many people are there, we cannot see. So in that situation, we say that it is not a set. For example, the strongest man in India or the strongest man in India, it is not defined because they cannot say who is the strongest person in India. So this kind of situation, this is not well defined. We don't know who is the person, who is the strongest man. So in that case, in that kind of situations, we say it is not a set. For example, let us take one more example. We have taken some of the things like one pen or a chair or a bench or book. We have collected some of the objects, these all the objects together. It doesn't have any relation between them. One pen, bench, something, book, chair, we have taken. But we don't have any relation between them. So what we have collected, the things, it is not defined. So that kind of situation, that kind of things put together is not called a set. So whatever the objects we have collected, so that should be well defined. So for example, we have taken some of the numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these numbers are well defined because natural numbers. So we have taken some of the things like one pen, pencil, eraser. These are all the things. We call these all stationery because we use these things. We use things for writing, erasing, and writing with the pencil. These all are stationery, and then we call these are sets. So these are together we call a set. So we take which are not related objects like a bulb or cloth or something, animal, we put together, we'll not call this one as a set. So whatever we have collected the objects, that must be defined. So we have taken before example, the number of students in a 10th class, the students of a 10th class are well defined objects because we know all the people. So in this manner, we can define the set. So example, we have written, so the students of 10th class is a set. So we have different types of sets here. Null set. Before going to the different types of sets, let's see how we'll represent the set. To represent all the elements of a set, so let's take some of the numbers. So these are the numbers. To represent this one as a set, we'll use the braces in this form. This we call braces. So we'll write all the objects in this braces. We'll call this a set of the numbers. We take any one of the things. We take three students' names. Ravi, Raju, Ram. We have taken three students' names. So this set of three students are together, we have written in a set. So in braces we have written. So this is called this all the people we have written in a set. So set of this people, the set of people, the number of people are three. So this is defined. So we'll use in this form to represent the set, we'll use this braces. So let's see how or the number of types of sets we have. Null set, finite set, infinite set, and equal sets, equivalent sets. This is the representation how we are using the diagrams to represent the set. So we'll just discuss about these all the types of sets. So first, starting with the null set. A set which consists of no elements and it is called null set, because sometimes we don't write anything in the set. So we ask how many numbers are present here. We did not write anything. So we call this as a null set or empty set or void set. Void. So null or empty. We can call this as empty set or void set. So that means that there are no elements are present in the set. We call this is null set or empty set or void set. So for example, this is a null set we call. And null set is represented by one of the symbol, it's a phi. We call this is phi. Phi we call phi. So let's go to the next one. Finite set. The number of elements of the set are countable. The number of elements in the set are countable. We are able to count the elements, how many number of elements are there in the set. We call this is finite set. So if we cannot count how many number of elements are present in the set, we call this is infinite set. For example, the set of natural numbers, the set of natural numbers, and so on, capital N. The set of natural numbers is infinite set, so we cannot define how many natural numbers are present, so that's why it is infinite. Equal sets. When we compare two sets, 1, 2, 3 equals to 1, 2, 3, the number of elements of the set, what are present here, that is equals to another set, it is 1, 2, 3, the same number of elements are present, and the same elements are present in two sets, we call them equal sets. For example, here we have one of the set A, let us name it as A. The set B, we call these are equal sets. A is equal to B, because this two sets A and B, we have the same number of elements and the same elements. So A equals to B, we call equivalent sets. The number of elements of the set are equal but need not to be the same elements, then we call them equivalent sets. Example is set of 1, 2, 3. Set A, set B, we have B, Q, R. So we call these two sets are equivalent sets. So equivalent sets are represented by this arrow mark. This equivalent sets we call. So the number of elements are equal in the two sets. So we call them equivalent sets. So equal sets we can call it as equivalent sets, but equivalent sets we cannot call equal sets, because the number of elements must be same in this. That's the reason we cannot call this sets as equal sets, but we can call this equal sets as equivalent sets. So let's recall again. So well-defined collection of objects is called set. So the set which doesn't contain any elements, we call it is void set or empty set. So finite set, number of elements will be countable in this. Infinite set, uncountable elements are present in this. So equal sets, the number of elements and the same elements are present. Equivalent sets, the number of elements are equal only, then we call equivalent sets. Let's go to the next one, using diagrams to represent the set or universal set. So using diagrams to represent the set, so to represent the sets, we will use some of the diagrams. We call them Venn diagrams or Euler diagrams. Venn, Euler diagrams. John Venn and Euler, they represented these sets, so that's why we call them John Venn or Euler diagrams. So short form, we call Venn diagrams. So let's take this. Using the diagrams to represent the set. Usually we represent these sets as circles. Set A, set B. For example, we have a set with elements of 1, 2, 3. The set with elements of 3, 4, 5. How to represent this set is, we'll write the circle. We'll write these all the elements of the set in the circle. That is 1, 2, 3. This one, we'll take the set B, this set A, and this set B. Set A. Set B, we'll write this is 3, 4, 5. Set A and set B. Set A we have 1, 2, 3. And set B we have 3, 4, 5. The elements we have represented. But when we observe these two sets, set A and set B, there is a common element of 3 in these two sets. So how to represent this set is, we need to intersect this both the circles in this manner. So this is a common space for the set A and set B when we have taken. So set A and set B. So the common space of these two is 3, because the element which is present for both set A and set B is 3. So here 3 is present, and this set B also we have 3 is present. Set A we have 1, 2. So let's write 1, 2 here. And set B we have 4, 5. We'll write 4, 5. So we will represent the sets in this form. So but all the sets of all the sets will write in this one of the rectangular box, that is in this manner. We call this is universal set. Universal set is represented by mu. Mu we call. This is mu, mu. So we call this set which consists of all the sets together, we call this is universal set. The set consists of all the sets. If we have the sets of A, B, C, D, and then we write all the sets together in this set. So this is represented by mu. Let's go to the next one. Sets. Well-defined collection of objects is called a set. Let's see what is A union B, intersection B, A minus B, and A is subset of B, A is superset of B. So here the symbol is union, A union B. So union means unite. The set of the elements of A and B combiningly we call union. The set of A union B. So intersection, the common elements of set A and B we call intersection, A intersection B. So if we subtract the elements of A from B, if we subtract the B from A, then we call this is A minus B, and A is subset of B. The elements of A, all the elements of A are present in B, then we call it A subset of B. Here, all the elements of B are present in A, then we call A superset of B. So let's start with A union B, union of the elements of A and B. For example, when we take the set A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, and set B is equals to 3, 4, 5. So to find the elements of A union B, let's write A union B. So to find out this, let's use the Venn diagram. So previously we have discussed about the Venn diagrams. So let's start with the Venn diagram. Set A and set B. Set A and B. The set A, we have the elements of 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3. and 4. Let's see, there is a common element in this both. These common elements in the both the set A and set B, that is 3 and 4. So here 3 and 4. This is the common element for both A and B. And 5, the element is 5. The set B. So 3, 4 common. 3 and 4 are common. Set A and B. That's the reason we have represented this one here. The region of A and B. So 3 and 4. This is the region.